Hello, good morning. Corey here again. I'm here to decorate my Hobonichi. So, as much as I love the pink, I thought I would use some of the Glitter Stories papers and the Tandy Art Girls to decorate the front of my book. So, I've got a few supplies here from Thompson Craft Supplies. Paint. I've got my gesso, got some matte medium gel from Finnebear, paintbrushes, some stencils and stamp, and I'm just going to use some of the elements from the papers and add it to the cover. So here we go. I'm going to start with my gesso just to add a bit of primer to the front of my book. So I'm adding this, it's soaking in quite quick. Just allows me to add the acrylic paints on because the book's made of fabric as well, so it's soaking in quite quick. So I'm just slapping that on. So for this month, I am guest designer for the month for Louise at Thompson's Craft Supplies. So she has sent me this lovely bundle here to use. Think that'll do. Let that dry for a second. Maybe should have had my craft mat then. Get that in a second. So I'll move these out of the way just now. Put a finger in that. I'm going to bring in my lovely messy craft mat. Just so I don't get paint all over my tabletop. There we go. This doesn't take long for your gesso to dry. It's a bit tacky, that'll be fine. I'm going to leave that to dry and I'll be back in a few seconds. Okay, so I've just gave that a little blast with the heat gun. See, it's a bit drier. It'll go a bit more transparent once it's dried, but you can, if you want to see more of the pink from your base, you can just use a clear gesso. So I might add in some paint. Just use my mat as a paint palette. Hence why it's covered in paint. So this is, I'll show you, Azure. This is a Finnebar paint. If I can get it to come out. There we go. Just a little bit dry in the top. A second. bring in the stencil. So this is Be Creative Every Day. I don't know if that's the name, but it's stencil ID 83. Yeah, I think it is Be Creative Every Day. Yeah. Okay, so what shall I use? I'll just use my paintbrush, I think. Yeah. Dab that on. I've not got a plan yet, I'm just going with it, see what happens. So some of this might end up covered up yet. There. See you just now. Cover myself in paint. As I say, no plan, just being messy. See what happens. Okay, if you want anything else. I'll leave that to dry, or I might just go and give it a blast with a heat gun again. I might add some of these actually with paint. Okay, so yeah, that's my plan. Could bring in the brayer for this one. See. Don't like wasting paint, so let me see. Ooh. Cover myself in paint. Sleeves up. Out the way. Okay, so what will I add next? I should add some pink. I love how bright this is. Look at that. And this is a fuchsia by Fabrica Decoro. Might just do the brayer again, but it pops them down here. Okay, like that actually. Nice and messy. There we go. And again, I'll leave that to dry. And I'll get some of my paper pieces ready to go. So I've cut up some of the papers here. Just to add to the front of my page. I've got the little girl with the pink hair. Two tags. For this tag, I cut out the centre here, the heart out the centre. So you can use that separate. And just punch the hole in the top of them. I've got a few extra little bits here from my stash I'm going to add in. So I'm going to start layering them up. I think I'll start with flower. Tag. I know I want the girl on the top. And then the heart popping out, something like this. Then once it's all together, you'd never know that I'd cut that out. So roughly that idea, a wee bit higher. Because then what I'm going to do is add in a bit of tulle. And my little shape here, add that one there for finishing touches. Okay, so start with the base, bring in my matte gel. Okay, I'm just going to use my finger to put that on. Now, I'm going to add a paper clip to this one, I think. So I'll add that before I stick it down. We'll glue it in place. Go sit underneath there like that. So don't want to add too much dimension to the front cover, just so that it lies flat or flat enough for when I'm writing in my book. Let's pop you under there. Sticks. It should be fine. That there. This matte medium dries clear once it's dry. Got little hearts here as well. I might just add on. I'm not decided if I want to paint them yet or not. I can always do that once they're dried. Worked. A little bit more glue. Now you could use a brush to put your glue on your pieces, but like most normal people, but I'm not normal. If you don't like getting too messy, then you can just use a brush. That's enough just now. Okay. Pop that away, and again, let that dry. Show you this. Liking how that's looking so far. Almost done. I think I might just add in some black or white scribbles, some doodles. And then I think that'll be it. I'm just going to go and wash my hands and get the glue off. Okay, so I've got my Posca pens here. Just get the black and get it out. Turn it around. Should do some splats. I'm gonna try it. See if this works. The pen's running out. Don't know if it'll work. Yep, it's not working. It's just done. Oh, wait a minute. Give me a second. I wonder. Try some ink. of. Like that so far. Let's see if the white. Give this a little splat. Kind of worked. Could just use white acrylic paint, that would probably be quicker. That's enough just now. Really like the way that's looking. I might paint the little hearts once they've dried. We paint them the blue. Yep, liking that. So thank you for watching, and I hope you've enjoyed my video.